Today's creative movement exercise could be used as a dance or ballet warm-up, or as a standalone dance experience, or part of storytelling. For example, in Swan Lake, we could retell the story of that ballet with selected excerpts from the story. We'll get a nice full body warm-up and a bit of a stretch while using our imagination. I'm the creator of Life Coach, and I help multi-passionate creatives dance through their difficulties and take leaps of faith into lives of fulfillment and joy. And I love providing joyful dance and mindful movement exercises for all ages. So this video is a part of that commitment to dance and movement that is joyful for young people, as well as for adults who have that creativity and desire, that youthful curiosity and inquiry. Special thanks to Vivi, who introduced me to this specific, or one variation of this specific warm-up, where we're running, walking and running as swans as part of our ballet warm-up. And there are different levels of this warm-up depending on skill and age. So I'll show a basic one, but of course that has evolved for me as I continue to practice it and continues to develop with my students as I teach them. But we'll start from off stage. I've made a little circle here. Of course, in class, the circle will become as big as the number of students that we have in class and the space that we have. Here I made it a little bit smaller. We can take that smaller for dancing at home. And I've just put three places out to mark the lake around which we will fly. And we will begin flying. One could use the little swan's music from Swan Lake, or a similar swan music. I've used a piece of swan music from the YouTube library for this piece. And we'll start walking gracefully, a ballet walk, toe ball heel around our leg with our swan wings flapping. And as we take that faster, it will become a smooth run with flying arms. And we'll continue that a couple of rounds, maybe 1 to 2 counts of 8. Then we'll transform onto the demi points, the tippy toes, into what you could say a butterfly or a hummingbird, with quicker arm movements and smaller, quicker foot movements, moving so quickly through our feet that they blur like a hummingbird. And we'll take a bit of that, a couple of circles depending on how big our space is. Then we'll transform again into flamingos, standing onto one leg in a parallel passe. So a high knee and over upper leg. That could be a big march, or turn it into a skip, or also practicing balance on our demi point. For more advanced dancers, we might also take counts for our rhythm. So taking 8 steps forward, for example, and 8 steps back, and then run again. We might spring, do some prances to warm up our feet and ankles and practice our jumping technique. And then we'll sit down like swans landing onto the lake, elegantly landing down onto our spot, forming a tiny ball or a swan egg, bringing our forehead towards the knees, curling in, and then we'll make a boat shape or fly our swan wings wide again a couple times as some core work, warming up our belly and our alignment, our control of our posture. We could add beats of our legs there, that's fun. And then at the end, we'll do a nice stretch over extended legs. Like the swan going to sleep, we'll tuck our head underneath the arms if possible. And and